In Tasmania.
Question for you folks. What art museum, what gallery has its own ferry? The answer is Mona in Hobart, of course. And that's where we're going today, the Museum of Old and New Art. Folks, here we are. The blaring music has just stopped, thank goodness. And it's about a 20-minute journey, and now we have these epic steps to climb. And there's our ferry that we just went on, and now we begin. Tennis court, I wonder if they ever play tennis on it. And a trampoline over there. Howdy doody. Yes, we're in to Mona. And I have my selfie stick in hand and the camera. Hopefully I can keep my sarcasm to a minimum so that we can enjoy this amazing, amazing place, which is supposedly amazing. But we'll see if it really is amazing or not. Yes, this is the entrance area, and they have timed entry. I tell you what, wow, hundreds and hundreds of people entering right now, and we are in COVID times. So it just goes to show that some places are still doing all right. As you saw outside, it's there's parts that are outside and parts that are inside, I've been told. And I guess we're about to experience Mona. Giant earthworm roaming through graves. Bulk Vesp Hurnar. They sound a bit Nordic to me. Honningbij. Hey, how you going? So while I'm traveling around, if I want to learn about what I'm looking at, there's a guide here that I download. Just go to your app store if you're here. They have free Wi-Fi here. I don't have any mobile reception. And I downloaded it, and I can find out what all these interesting things are up here. This is in the corner there, that's called Punked. And the guy sits there, and eventually, if you wait long enough, that happens. Now, is it a skit for Monty Python or art? That's for you to decide. It's a rock. That's right, a real, well actually probably not real, it doesn't look real. And on the other side of this rock, it turns out you can go inside. You have to queue up, only two people at a time it seems. So we will see just how exciting this amazing piece of art is. Oh look, it's a mirror. With a couple of mirrors, and it looks like with small doors. Yes. Please give me $1 million. So I was talking to my cousin in Hobart about this place, and she said it's definitely a case of love it or hate it. I don't know where I'm sitting right now. We're in the line to see something, but I don't know what it is. It could be amazing. It could be more amazing. We also have Alberta Einstein over here, and she may well be a piece of art too. I don't know. It appears to be called 2050, and it's by Richard Wilson. And there's only one person in front of me. So this should be pretty awesome. Recycled engine oil. And it's full. Well, there you go. Recycled engine oil, folks. Do not want to miss that when you're here. A giant pool of recycled engine oil. So folks, we've gone up to the next level now. We're on basement 2. And I've been seeing this. This is a whole room of books, which are just white. Ooh la la. Have they had the books made? Why don't we sit down and have a read? See. All the pages. I know what you're thinking. Who did this amazing piece of art? Who had the time in their life to construct IKEA bookshelves and put completely white books, which no doubt they made in them. I'll tell you in just a second.
Sorry mate, please don't sit down on the table.
Oh okay, I thought that was part of the thing. Sorry.
That's okay.
I feel like a complete idiot now. Thank you.
No, that's all right.
I mean, that's not your fault. It's my fault. Well, that was dreadfully embarrassing. I was not supposed to sit at that table. So now I feel like an absolute idiot. This is, this is nobody's happy place, this. God, he's ready to meet me. Excuse all the blood. My darling, may her guts rot in hell. I love her so much. Henry, I really should be showing you this. Off we to saying, if you're reading this, I've succeeded in drinking enough piss to kill myself. I bet you he didn't. I bet you he didn't. Is it supposed to uplift? Because often it does the exact opposite. Auto by Randy Palumbo. This is a couch. It's also on a piece of art called My Beautiful Chair. It's a giant head. With flashy, flashy lights inside. Cool animation. So what we have here is Cloaca Professional 210 piece by Wim Devoy from Belgium. And what is it? This is basically a mechanical replication of the digestion system going from food all the way down to pieces. And you know what? It smells like that. And you may be wondering why? I don't know. Okay, folks, get ready for the next piece of art. This is the Ladies' Wall by Men. A friend of mine quite colourfully characterised this as the wall of vaginas. This one's kind of cool. Back outside, we've done the inside bit, we have a little look around, but we need some time for reflection, I think. So Also time for a food. Not short on a place for chilling, Mona. It's hard to deny that this is a lovely, lovely space here. Up there you've got two restaurants, plus you've got a little bar there that does a bit of food, plus you've got a place that does burgers, and I had a wallaby burger. This is the first time I've eaten wallaby in my life, and it was here at the Museum of Old and New Art in Hobart, Tasmania. There's supposed to be lots of stuff around the grounds, I don't know. Here we are. We are above the Faro Bar, one of the restaurants here at Mona, with an absolutely sensational view. One, I must say, more attractive than probably any of the artwork that I've seen today. Can a walkway be art? Sure, why not? So folks, that's pretty much it for Mona. How do I sum it up? I don't know. It's an incredible space and the outdoor area is just stunningly beautiful. It's a museum that's, you know, inside a hill. The indoor space is incredible and unlike anything I've ever seen before. However, the stuff that they've actually chosen to put in it, some of it's interesting. I wouldn't say any of it I was particularly impressed by. Modern art is not my thing, but wow, they really pushed the boundaries. Maybe that's the whole point of a place like Mona. I don't know. You know, there were school groups there, but I don't know that I'd take my children to see it. Perhaps they kept them off the third floor with all the vaginas, I don't know. If you are into your weird and wonderful, then possibly this is going to amaze you. And as people have told me, you either love it or hate it. I don't think I did either. And I'm glad I can say I've been here. But at the same time, I think I'm going to be pretty happy to hop that ferry back to Hobart Town. Thank you very much for joining me. Take care. May the journey never end. Hey, Mona. Ooh, Mona. Ba-do-ba. Hey, Mona. Ooh, Mona. I think Craig McLaughlin actually came up with those lyrics himself.